One approach to creating a less predictable music track is to ensure that the various segments of a song, like a verse, bridge, and chorus, don't always play back in the same order. In this case, for the Wwise demo project, we have segments like Explore, Explore Bridge, Explore Piano, etc. that have already been configured with the correct tempo and entry-exit cues. To make the music less predictable, we want to have Wwise automatically choose what segments play and to some degree have their order randomized. This is known as resequencing, or sometimes referred to as a horizontal approach to dynamic music integration. The first step is to place the music segments within a system that can make decisions about when each of these music segments should play. In Wwise, this is done within an object called a music playlist container. First, we'll select the music segments, right-click, and choose New Parent, Music Playlist Container. These music segments are all related to the Explore music, so we'll name the new object Explore. One very important thing to consider is that music playlist containers have a tempo property, just like the music segments do. If we select the Explore object, we can see that it's set up to the default tempo of 120. Which is different from the 138 beats per minute originally set for the music segments contained within. Tempo is a property that falls into the inheritance system used throughout Wwise, so when you choose a music segment contained within, we can see that its tempo is grayed out and that it says 120. This is because it received the tempo from its parent. To resolve this, we can go back to the newly created Explore object and change its tempo to 138. And now we can see the proper tempo is reflected in the child objects contained within. Now this works because all of the music for this particular song is played at 138 beats per minute. This now allows it to maintain the waveform's alignment with the musical grid. This is not the case for time signature. If we move down to the Explore, Trans to Bridge, we can see that it's in 3/4 time. However, even though it was originally configured in 3/4 time, it's currently inheriting its time signature from its parent object. To fix this, you just need to click the Override Parent checkbox, and its originally set time signature of 3/4 time is restored. The Music Playlist container does exactly what its name implies. It plays a list of its contained objects one after another. But currently, if we try to select the Explore Music Playlist container, and then we try to play it, we won't be allowed. This is because we have yet to define which order we want the objects to play in. To do this, we just drag the music segments to the Music Playlist editor in the order that you want them to play. We'll start with the arpeggio. We'll skip the bridge, and then go straight to piano. Followed by the rhythm, ending with the theme. We're dragging to a destination just under where it says Sequence Continuous. This line represents a concept called a group. All music playlists have at least one group, but more can be added. More on that in the next section, but for now, let's test the arrangement. We'll go back and select the Explore Music Playlist container and click Play. As the music plays, we're going to see the play icon. The important thing to watch is what happens as the music transitions from one segment to the other. You'll see that for a moment, two play icons play simultaneously. This is because post-exit material from the first music segment is allowed to play over the beginning of the next music segment. In fact, the exit cue of the first music segment will be perfectly aligned in time with the entry cue of the second music segment. This is how smooth transitions between segments occur. Refer to the Importing and Preparing Music Segments video for more information on configuring entry and exit cues. It's easy to rearrange the order of music segments and still retain nice smooth transitions. In fact, we can have Wwise rearrange the segments on the fly for us by simply changing the group to Random Continuous. Now each time we play the Explore Music playlist container, it will randomly choose one of the contained segments. So there, it chose Piano. Now it chose the arpeggio. Now the piano again. And this time, the rhythm. Sometimes you have a segment that might sound great every now and then, but when used too often might get annoying. We can lower a music segment's weighting, as we'll do for the rhythm. We'll set it to a value of 25. Now it's less likely to be chosen. To repeat music segments multiple times, you can modify its loop property. To have the arpeggio play twice before moving to the next segment, we can simply set its loop property value to 2. In some cases, we might want to randomize how many times it loops. We can see the randomizer icon next to the value. If we double-click it, we can choose Enable and set its minimum offset to -1 and a maximum offset to +1. And now, when the arpeggio part is played, it will randomize it anywhere from 1 to 3 times before moving to the next section. Currently, the playlist will stop when the end of the playlist is reached. Because we don't know how long the player will be exploring, we can set the entire playlist to loop by looping the group. Just click the down arrow to the right of the loop value and it will change to infinite. It's possible to create multiple groups within a playlist container to provide even more control over the arrangement. In Cube, when a level begins, the player starts by exploring the world around them. Let's configure it so that the main theme is always heard first, followed by playing the remaining segments. We'll start by first selecting the last line in the list and clicking the New Group button. A new group is added below. Now we can drag everything but the main theme into the new group. In this case, we'll need to go back and set the first group to Sequence Continuous, and set the new group to Random Continuous. If you look at the flow, the music playlist container will first play the theme before moving to the next line, which is the group, which will then randomly play through the remaining music segments before it repeats back to the beginning and starts all over again. Objects within the music playlist editor can be moved between hierarchies, which can make for a big difference in the outcome. To show this, we'll add in the bridge to the end of the playlist. Now currently, the bridge is just one of the randomly selected music segments, along with arpeggio, piano, and rhythm. But notice that I can move it to the left, and dotted lines will indicate how it will be promoted in the hierarchy. In this arrangement, the theme plays followed by the rhythm, piano, or arpeggio, and then it ends with the bridge. There's also a Trans to Bridge section. It provides a brief musical interlude to the bridge section, but let's say we only want to hear it every other time the bridge is played. To create this, we'll create a sequence step group, and then move the Explore Bridge into that new group. Within that group, we'll add yet another group, and we'll leave it as Sequence Continuous. And then we'll add Trans to Bridge, then followed by the bridge. Now let's talk down the arrangement. It starts with the theme, followed by a random order of arpeggio, piano, or rhythm parts, and then plays the bridge music. At this point, it loops back to the beginning, plays the theme again, followed by a random order of arpeggio, piano, and rhythm parts, but this time it jumps down and plays the Trans to Bridge, followed by the bridge, and then repeats back to the beginning and starts the process all over again. To test it, it can sometimes take a little time to play everything. So one trick is when you play the music container, in this case, the Explore Music Playlist container, we can go to that object's playback speed and turn the playback speed up. It might sound a little strange, but it allows you to see the transition system at work. Just make sure you return it back to the original value.